Prayer against witchcraft, manipulation, and controlling spirit. Prayer against witchcraft, manipulations, and controlling spirit. There are prayers we are going to do about witchcraft, manipulation. Some people, they don't know witchcraft, manipulation, how they control people. There are some powers of witchcraft, controlling and manipulation. Manipulation and controlling. I'm going to talk about this, and you will see in the Bible how that spirit controls people and manipulate people. I'm going to read from the book of Romans 16, verse 18. Let me pray. My Father and my God, in the name of Jesus, I come before you, before your presence, God. My Father and my God, I lift up your name, God. I worship you, Lord. I thank you. I committed this message to you, Lord, my Father. In the name of Jesus, I bleed the blood of Jesus. I bleed the blood of Jesus. I bleed the blood of Jesus over this message. My God and my Father, in the name of Jesus, I destroy the powers of manipulation. I destroy every powers of manipulation and controlling. I destroy witchcraft, manipulate, witchcraft, controlling, powers of witchcraft, controlling spirit. I bind you, I destroy you to get out of the life of these people. Get out of the life of anyone that is being controlled by spirit of witchcraft, manipulation. Manipulation, witchcraft, I bind you. I know people, they don't want to hear this message because they feel like I'm exposing them. I am exposing them, you, because you are not doing the right thing. You are doing witchcraft. You are a manipulator. Anybody who is manipulating and controlling, that is a witchcraft. And I'm going to read from the book of Romans 16, verse 18. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. My Father, I thank you. I thank you, Lord. You are wonderful. Thank you, Father. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes. Thank you. The subject I'm talking is witchcraft, manipulation, and controlling spirit. Witchcraft, manipulation, and controlling spirit. And I'm going to read from the book of Romans 16, verse 18. The Bible says, for such a man are slaves, not of our Lord Jesus Christ, but of their own habits, and by their own smooth and flattering speech, they deceive the hearts of unsuspecting. You see, there are men who are slaves for themselves, not of our Lord Jesus Christ. There are some men, the Bible calls, there are some men who are slaves for themselves. Witchcraft, they are slaves for themselves. They are not slaves for our Lord Jesus Christ. They are not working for God. They are not slaves for our Lord Jesus Christ. It is, they are slaves by themselves. This is what the Bible says. That is witchcraft. That is witchcraft, because the Bible says that, and for such a man are slaves, not of our Lord Jesus Christ, but of their own habits, and by their smooth and flattering speech, they deceive the hearts of unsuspecting. So these people, they have flattering speech. They flat people. They talk deceiving people, the heart of unsuspecting, the heart of simple people, the heart of people who trapped very easily. Simple. Yeah? These are the witchcraft spirit. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, I want to thank you, Father. I thank you, Jesus. I give you all the glory, God. Loving Father, I honor you, Lord. I praise your name. I thank you. Jesus, I give you all the glory. Hallelujah. Hello? Can everybody can hear me? Yes. Prayer line, can you hear me? Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. Jesus, I thank you, Lord. I give you all the glory, my God. My Father and my God, I thank you. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, you can hear me. I know. So, you see, these men, they are not of our Lord Jesus Christ, but they are of their own habits, and by their own smooth and flattering speech, they deceive the hearts of unsuspecting, which means they deceive the heart of simple people. They speak flattering speech. They deceive the hearts of unsuspecting. You know, these people, they have manipulation spirits. They have witchcraft, manipulation, and controlling spirit. Now, they flat people, flatting. They don't tell the people the truth. They flat them. And the Bible is talking to us, is warning us and telling us there are some people in your life. Look at the book of 2 Peter 2, verse 18, what it says. For speaking out arrogance, words of vanity, they entice by fleshly desire, by sensitivity, those who barely escape from the ones who live in errors. You know, this witchcraft manipulation, they are so arrogant. They are so proud. They are arrogant. Their words is infinities, ticing by fresh desires. These are witchcraft manipulation controlling. They are very arrogant. They want to control everything. They want to rule and deceive people. The Bible describes them in 2 Corinthians 11, verse 13 to 15. That is how the Bible describes them. They are called, for such are false prophets, false apostles, deceitful workers, transforming themselves unto apostles of Christ. And no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of the light. Therefore, it is no great thing if these ministers also be transformed as the minister of the righteous, who end shall be according to their works. You see, now, this witchcraft manipulation controlling spirit, they are described in 2 Corinthians 11, verse 13 to 15, they are false apostles, deceitful workers, transforming themselves unto apostles of Christ. And no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed unto angel of the light. These are the ones who controlling people, who manipulate people. They call themselves apostles. They are false apostles, deceitful works, transforming themselves unto the apostle of Christ. The Bible score is saying, and no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed unto an angel of the right. They transformed, even Satan can transform himself unto the angel of the right. And they are not in the right. They are in the dark. They call themselves, they are false. The Bible is telling us those people, they are called false apostles. You see, apostles so and so, but they are full of deceit, full of witchcraft, manipulation and controlling, flattering language, flattering speech. They only know how to deceive people. The Bible is saying in Ephesians 4, verse 14, as a result, we are no longer to be children tossed here and there by waves and carried about by every wind of doctrine, but by trickery of men, by crafts in deceiving scheming. Here now, you can see there are craftiness. Craftiness means witchcraft. In deceiving scheming. Ephesians 4 verse 14 says, as a result, we are no longer to be children tossed here and there by waves and carried about by every wind of doctrine, by the trickery of men, by craftiness in deceiving scheming. So this witchcraft manipulation controlling, their work is to deceive people. Their schemes is to deceive people. They want to deceive people to control them. They want to deceive people to manipulate them. Their work is manipulating and deceiving and controlling people. Now, when you look at Ephesians 5 or 6, the Bible says, "Let no one deceive you with empty words, for because of these things, the wrath of God comes upon sons of disobedience." So the Bible is telling us, let no one deceive you with empty words, for because of these things, the wrath of God comes upon the sons of disobedience. Witchcraft, manipulation, witchcraft is people who are rebellion. So when you are a rebel, you are disobedient, you are a witchcraft. That's what the Bible calls you. It is described like that. So in another way, the children of disobedience, they are called witchcraft. They are empty words. The Bible is warning us, do not let them to deceive you. The Bible says, my people perish because of lack of knowledge. Since people, they don't want to get knowledge, they are deceived. Ignorance is a bad thing. Study the word of God. Study your Bible and see. Don't be deceived by this manipulation, witchcraft, empty words. The Bible is calling here them. They are a deceiver. They deceive you with empty words. Because they deceive you with empty words, where they are not taking you to anywhere. They are taking you to hellfire. They are deceiving you and controlling you, manipulating you, ruling you, scheming to deceive you. The Bible says the last day they will come. They will say, here is Jesus. They will say and deceive so many people. So these powers of witchcraft and people, they believe them because they have spell on them. They have chants on them, as we were started yesterday. So people, they are following them. Multitude, thousands are will follow them. Once they have this spiritual, they have power of controlling and manipulation. Therefore, people of God, we need to come against this power. We need to bleed the blood of Jesus and pray that any witchcraft, any controlling witchcraft manipulation over your life and your children, let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. We pray that God Almighty will destroy them and stop them and put them a stop. Because this is very serious. If you see the Bible, the way it's calling them in another way, in another name, you might be wondering what kind of these people, when the Bible is calling them, such are the false prophets, deceitful works, transforming themselves unto the apostles of Christ. You see, these are witchcraft apostles. These are witchcraft children of the devil who are manipulating people and deceiving them. Therefore, I pray that God Almighty will deliver you from the hands of such a false apostles. May God deliver you and let your eyes be open. Let God give you discerning spirit to discern what kind of a pastor you have. These are the ones who are having multitude and they are all over the world now. These are witchcraft apostles. They call themselves, they transform themselves into apostles of Christ. But they are witchcraft apostles of Christ. Not all apostles you see. Apostle so-and-so is a child of God. Most of them, they are children of the devil. They are witchcraft, manipulating, controlling. They are there to control. Look at what the Bible says. The Bible is saying that if you look at this, they say, Romans 16, verse 18, it says, "For such men are slaves, not only not of our Lord Jesus Christ, but of their own habits. And by their own smooth and their flattering speech, they deceive the hearts of unsuspecting." So when they get some people who does not study their Bible, they don't know anything. They are deceived very well. And people, they believe that they are telling them the truth because they have spirit of smooth, flattering. They can flatter, they talk nice. They sympathize with you. They cry with you. They talk so well. And when you hear when they talk so well, you cannot even think of anything. They just manipulate your head, manipulate your mind, and controlling you. Now, when they're controlling, it is very difficult to get out of them. they put spells on you. After putting spells on you, now they can do you anything they want, because they have already flood you with words. Flooding. Look at that. Let me see King James, what does the King James says? The flooding words. They talk very good until you don't want to leave them. And they are destroying you. They are taking you to hellfire. Those are witchcraft, manipulating, controlling. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. My God, I want to thank you so much that God will deliver you from the hands of manipulator and controlling demons and controlling evil people. So we pray that God Almighty will help us. The Bible says in Romans 16, verse 8, let me look at King James, what it says. Hallelujah. It says, For they that are such as serve not our Lord Jesus Christ, but their own belly. They serve their own belly, and by good works and fair speeches deceive the hearts of the simple. They deceive the hearts of simple. Those people, they are after their belly. Please look at the Bible. These are witchcraft manipulation. They can have, I said yesterday, they have big houses, they have cars. I know one church in Africa. This church, they have a lot of people, but it was only pastor. The bishop was the only who was having the car. He was having cars, about four of them. But his members, everybody, they were no car. They didn't have cars. And this bishop, he was the one who was living in a big house. And people were contributing, they were doing fundraising every week, every time, and all the money he was taking. In Africa, it's not like here that you have to write your any problem and you are accountable. But there, it is nothing like that. So this bishop, he started using this money and he was having affairs with his own member. He was giving them money and doing so wicked and deceive them. Those women who are working in the banks, managers, all of them, he was sleeping with them. And because of these witchcraft spells and chants, the women could not realize and they could not see what was this man was doing. Even his own wife, he could not talk anything. So when you are under this controlling of such a witchcraft manipulation, you can't come out unless you know you can be helped with a spiritual a deliverance minister to deliver you. And also, when you are influenced with that witchcraft manipulation, it is very difficult to come out of them. But I pray that anyone, that's why we need to pray these prayers, because there are some people who are under heavy witchcraft controlling manipulation that they cannot be able to come out. We pray that God will release them. We pray that God would wash away those manipulation spells and witchcraft that have been affecting them. It is our prayer that would set these people free from the hands of those manipulators, witchcraft controllers. Like people are in the prison, they are captured. They are in the gate of the devil. They don't know anything. They cannot come out from that prison. It is our prayer to release them from them. Now, when we pray for these people, God will hear our prayer and release those people. I pray because I know how much people are suffering in the hands of those false apostles, as the Bible described them. Therefore, I pray that God Almighty will deliver. And if some of you are under such a witchcraft controlling manipulation, God will deliver you tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Some people, they are in the church, and when they are in the church, you see it's only the pastor who is doing well. Other people are doing nothing. People are suffering. It's only the pastor who is doing well in that church, and they cannot see what's wrong with our member. Why is it? Sometimes you see there's a lot of deaths. People are dying in the church. They are sick and they are sick because of heavy spells and witchcraft. They have been witched by this pastors who are flooding them with the words, with their smooth words. Repeat it. Just check that the the book of Romans and see who kind, what kind of people is that. Those are witchcraft, manipulation, controlling spirit of the of types of people who are operating there. They are not for our Lord Jesus Christ. Then who are they? Who are they serving? They are serving the devil. Who is Lucifer? And who is that? Who is serving Lucifer? Who is serving Satan? It's the witchcraft. It's the evil people. So therefore, children of God, we are not ignorant for the schemes of witchcraft. We are not ignorant for the schemes of the devil. Therefore, I pray that God would destroy everything planted with the witchcraft in the name of Jesus. I bring the blood of Jesus between the powers of darkness in the name of Jesus Christ. I bring the power, the blood of Jesus between witchcraft, manipulation, controlling spirit, and the spirit of darkness in the name of Jesus Christ. I destroy them by the power in the blood of Jesus. I pray those who are being under controlling of witchcraft, manipulation, spirits, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will deliver them wherever they are, anywhere in the world, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. If you are the victim of witchcraft, manipulation, controlling, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Even your husband can be a witch, controlling and manipulating. You don't know, these are the spirits. It is a spirit. Yeah? You can have a husband who is so controlling and manipulating. That is witchcraft. That is witchcraft. It's not normal. Those are witchcraft spirit controlling you. You can have a wife who is so controlling, manipulating, under heavy influence of demons. That is witchcraft. It's not normal. You can have a brother, a sister who is so controlling. He wants to rule. He's the one who wants to take over and rule out of manipulating people and controlling people. That is witchcraft. Therefore, I pray that God will deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. At the workplace, your boss is controlling. He doesn't want to let people to breathe. He's manipulating and controlling everything. He doesn't want to let the people even to say anything. He's the only one who is talking. That is witchcraft, manipulation, controlling spirit. You might see a place where leaders, they don't want anybody to do anything. They are the ones, everything. That's witchcraft, manipulation, controlling with their smooth, flattering words. They deceive people. Therefore, I pray that God will destroy every deceiving, flattering, smooth words from these false prophets, false evil people in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my God and my Father, in the name of Jesus, I command every evil monitoring spirit to leave you now in the name of Jesus. I renounce Satan and his host and declare them to be your enemies and let them go and get away from your life in Jesus' name. I pray for those who are being controlled by witchcraft spirits. Let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. Manipulation controlling spirit, I bind you. I destroy you. I command you to get out of these people. I destroy you in the name of Jesus. You are a liar. Get out from these people. Get out from this man. Get out from this woman. By the power in the blood of Jesus. My Father and my God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I want to thank you. I exercise my authority over stubborn witchcraft and I pull down their structure in the name of Jesus. I take authority against stubborn witchcraft. I pull them down in the name of Jesus Christ. Every stubborn witchcraft, I destroy them. I pull them down in the name of Jesus Christ. Stubborn witchcraft, manipulation and controlling witchcraft. You are a liar. I pull you down. I destroy you. I destroy your works. I destroy your power. You will not manifest. You will not prosper in Jesus' name. Your time is up in the mighty name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I thank you, Lord Jesus. I give you all the glory, my God. My Father and my God, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I bless your name. I thank you, Jesus. My God, I give you all the glory. Let the blood of Jesus cancel every witchcraft incision fashioned against your destiny in the name of Jesus. Every witchcraft portions be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Let every witchcraft portion be destroyed by fire, by thunder, in the name of Jesus. I bind and destroy them in the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I want to thank you. I thank you, God. I give you all the glory, my God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we love you. Lord, we thank you. Lord, I give you all the glory. I destroy the works of the enemy. I destroy every false prophet. I destroy every false teacher. Lord, my Father, I pray that God open the eyes of your people. Let your people have discerning eyes to see so that they cannot be deceived, so that they cannot be erred by the wicked and personality that have raised up in the world to deceive people in the name of Jesus Christ. My God, I plead the blood of Jesus. I bleed the blood of Jesus. I reverse every witchcraft pattern fashioned against your destiny in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every witchcraft pattern that is fashioned against you, I destroy them. I bind them. I reverse every witchcraft pattern fashioned against your destiny in the mighty name of Jesus. Every witchcraft gauge fashioned against your life be destroyed in the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I pray that God Almighty, let every problem in your life that originated from witchcraft receive divine and instant solution in the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, in the name of Jesus, I command all damage done to your life by witchcraft to be repaired in the name of Jesus Christ. My God and my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, let every blessing confiscated by witchcraft spirit be released in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, every witchcraft power assigned against your life and your marriage, I pray, I receive thunder and lightning of God in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that let every camp of witchcraft gathered against your prosperity fall down and die in the name of Jesus Christ. Let them fall down and die. Every camp of witchcraft gathered against your prosperity, fall down and die in the name of Jesus. Every witchcraft plot working against you, I bring judgment of God against you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God and my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I destroy every activities of witchcraft working against your life, working against your children, working against the work of your hand, in the mighty name of Jesus, working against the work of your labor, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God and my Father, I destroy you, witchcraft manipulation controlling. You are a liar. Get out of these people. Out in the name of Jesus. I bind you. I resist you. I render you powerless. Lose your power. You are a liar. In the name of Jesus, be exposed and be disgraced. All these people you are deceiving, everyone you are being manipulated, you spell on them. You put a chance and spells against the people. You manipulate them by the power and the blood of Jesus. Let that spells and manipulator, spells and chance die. Let every spells and jams that you are spelling to people to die. Let them lose their direction. Let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. Let them catify and burn to ashes. I bleed the blood of Jesus over these people, Lord. Let your wind blow to wherever who is being affected by these wicked people who are using spells and charms against the people, and they are making them to become stupid. They become confused. Let these people, God, to found guilty, and let your judgment fall upon them in the name of Jesus. Let your judgment, God, fall upon such a people in the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I pray that God, tonight, my Father, I pray, set your people free. Set your people from witchcraft manipulation controlling. Set your people free from those people who are being controlling, even their husband and wives who are being witched, who have been using witchcraft against their wives, against their husband, against their children. Children are using witchcraft against their parents, against their other children, against their brothers and sisters. Father, I pray that God wash you these people, protect them, Lord, from this witchcraft manipulation and other stuff these people are using. God, deliver them. Deliver your people, my Father, in the name of Jesus. I pray, God, in the name of Jesus, anyone that is using spells and chants against anybody here, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Let their spells and chants turn to themselves, turn against themselves in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, I thank you, Father. I give you all the glory. I give you all the honor in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. I want to thank God so much for you. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you so much. This is your host, Dr. Christine Isigi, saying bye-bye to you. I have to stop here. Tomorrow we are continuing. What the Holy Spirit will give me, I will pull it up and we will continue. Remember to study this scripture that I have given to you, and you will never be deceived. Don't be deceived. Don't be lied. Don't be deceived. There is some spirit moving now, walking in the world, deceiving even the chosen people. You are not ignorant. You are not blind. You are a discerning spirit, and God will help you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray that God will deliver you and open your eyes to see and to know. The Bible says, my people are perishing because of lack of knowledge. Please study your word, study your Bible, and take time with God. Pray so that you cannot be deceived. They are smarters. They talk nice. They do everything, but they are false apostles. They are false prophets. They are false teachers who transform themselves to the right, but they are not living in the right. They are living in darkness. Therefore, be careful, people of God, that you will never be manipulated. Anyone who is manipulating people is a witchcraft. Is a witch. That one is a witchcraft automatically. It's not nice. So so if you see somebody like this, fire, send the fire of God. Send thunder and the fire of God. Let them thunder them in the name of Jesus. Yes, I'm going to give you our email address. Our email address is overcomersdhm@gmail.com. And our number to call me is 647-608-5207. Call me. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi. Call Christine Isigi, will help you. I have knowledge. I have so much. I have a lot of knowledge about this work that I'm doing. It cost me big. It's not easy. And through the grace of God, I do research, and also the people I pray with, some of them, they are witchcraft, they get saved, and they tell me all this. So thank you very much. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Yes, my sister Deborah is there, is asking people to donate, and I thank you for those people who are donating. I love you, and I thank you so much for your donation. I really appreciate so much. I told you we have orphanages, we are helping. We have Mozambique. Dr. Juma Masinde is there right now. She should come this week or next week. She will be here and you will see. We have orphanage. We help those children and youths and single mothers and widows. We have 3 orphanage. And I thank God for your money that you are giving. It is doing good job. We have pastors who are in the village. They are praying for us and they are working so hard. So we supported them. We thank God that God is good. So please, go to donate. And if you want to visit Africa, if you want to go and visit your children or the project in Africa, you are welcome. Let us know so that we can arrange. Also, we have our barbecue, Niagara Falls, and we will be going to Niagara in the lake. Pastor Mark will explain this properly because he's the one who is organized this. And they say, pass, which takes people. If you are coming from States, there's a bus will take you and bring you back to the hotel or back to your country. But we leave you at the airport. So if you want to join us, you are welcome. It will be on 20th of this month, 20th of this month of August. So you are most welcome. I like a big number to come. The bus is big. So we need some people who drive themselves. So the bus is there for guests. Those people want to come and join us. Thank you very much, and have a wonderful evening or a wonderful morning. Australia, I think it's a morning now. So I thank you so much. I love you so much. There's nothing I can do about it. I love you. I love you, and that's what I don't pretend. I love you. Thank you so much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. Bye. Bye.